stretch rock promenades and a 50p increase on all existing parking tariffs. And indeed, Mr. Mayor, since this was put forward, so great was the groundswell of public opinion against those charges that the Leeds Borough Council performed an embarrassing partial U-turn and postponed charges in our town centres in Brighton, West Kirby, Brighton, Seafronts, which of course I welcome. But for some inexplicable reason, Mr. Mayor, he's ignored the over 17,000 people who have told him they're against any charges in our country parks. And Mr. Mayor, it gives me absolutely no pleasure at all to be standing before you tonight to debate the administration's wanton disregard for those residents who have said no to any car parking charges.
Hypocrisy.
I find it simply staggering that the Leader of the Council and his Labour colleagues are ignoring such a significant number of people that they are elected to represent. Our residents haven't been hoodwinked, Mr. Mayor, by the Council's leader's assertion that if he doesn't consider increasing charges, he'll have to make cuts in the budget, such as social care. The Leader of the Council knows as well as I do that any surplus income from off-street car parking will be used to fund traffic-related expenditure, improvements, maintenance, highways, and so on. And it's clear that it cannot lawfully be used to fund social care. So I really hope the Leader of the Council isn't being swayed into parroting alternative facts by his trusted media advisers. Mr. Mayor, what Wirral Council taxpayers know is that they already pay for the upkeep of our parks via the annual council tax they pay. And they should not be charged twice for the use of the parks by the imposition of any parking charges. Mr. Mayor, if the council leader needs any assistance in finding an alternative funding source for keeping parks free for everyone to use and access, our budget amendment to the following council makes it crystal clear that he should abandon his unnecessary, unwanted, and undelivered vanity project, that is the council newspaper Wirral View, and use 152,000 revenue saving to reject those these charging proposals. Mr. Mayor, the Leader of the Council claims to have listened to business owners when making his U-turn, and I can assure you that he hasn't listened to the owners of the Red Rooms Cafe in Arrow Park, GJ's Coffee Shop in Wirral Country Park, the Mimosa Cafe in Eastern Country Park, and the Barking Mad Cafe run by the Friends of Royden Park, who, Mr. Mayor, have grave concerns over the survival of their businesses if the council leader pursues this tax on fresh air. And it's not only the businesses associated with country parks that have expressed their utter dismay and the opposition to proposed charges. The chairman of local grassroots junior football club has made an impassioned plea explaining how any charges will impact on their membership and implore the council to think again. And I too would encourage the leader to think again about the unfair parking charges and the serious effect it will have on children. The Friends of Royden Park also wrote a comprehensive response to the council's TRO, explaining how the Friends are tackling issues of social isolation, providing a meeting place for vulnerable adults, and encouraging families to use the park for a healthy and inexpensive day out. The chair clearly articulated that there's been universal opposition against the Labour leaders' parking charges and Friends group, which has raised over £25,000 to improve park facilities. Mr. Mayor, the Leader of the Council has made much of his aspiration for the council to be more commercial. He would do well to follow the lead of successful commercial operations such as Marks & Spencer, Sainsbury's, Tesco's, Aldi and Asda, who I think I'm correct in saying have plenty of free parking for the use of their customers. Mr. Mayor, I believe that any increase in car parking tariffs will have a damaging effect on Wirral's high street. It will have a damaging effect on Wirral's country parks, and I urge council to accept our special resolution and notice of motion. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
The Tory government. Shame on you, you hypocrite, they're Tory cuts.
Okay, can we have speakers on the floor, please? That's Steve Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I believe that these car parking charging proposals should be withdrawn due to the strong public vehicles. They're not wanted for economic and health reasons. However, there is another consideration that members should also be aware of, and that is parking enforcement. Parking charges are only effective if they're properly administered and if defaulters are processed correctly. This is where Wirral seems to have a problem. I refer to the council's latest annual report on parking enforcement, which was published in March 2016. Section 5.1 of this report shows the financial information for the last 5 years. 2011 shows a deficit of £31,000. 2012 went up to £61,000. 2013 up to £84,000. In 2014, the deficit did drop, but it was still a loss of £56,000. And then in 2015, the deficit leaped up to a massive £119,000. These losses to Wirral total £351,000. So, Mr. Mayor, in conclusion, as well as the immense public concern for the economic and well-being factors, I would ask members to bear in mind these enforcement losses we are already encountering and vote against this proposal. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Blame the Tory government.
Activities, but most of all, it will affect your
Yeah, ask Theresa May for some money.
If this increase is voted through, I hope there will be transparency with regards to where the revenue for this ends up, as all revenue raised should be diverted back into the parks for environmental improvements, as agreed in the legislation. I truly believe it would be a terrible mistake to impose these charges on Wirral Parks and penalise the simple pleasure for the people of Wirral are being very vocal in their displeasure at this proposal. So, Mr. Mayor, I support the Conservative amendment.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The dire financial situation as Council finds itself in because the Tory party's ideology, whether it's to a fair still support, have been well reversed. That said, despite the loss of over £100 million, this Labour administration has approved any libraries or leisure centres. Given this, and the further savings that these new found, it's advice that officers come up with their options in order to bridge the budget gap, which in 2017-18 is £49 million over. Before the publication of the original officer proposals, I spent a considerable amount of time visiting and talking to local people and businesses. It became clear that there was genuine concern about scale and scope of the proposed charges. I shared that concern. As the listening administration, officers were told to think again. As a result, the infrastructure charges in new areas such as Bromborough and New Brighton were put together. Mr. Mayor, I appreciate that driving one will support the 23 increase in tariffs. However, it has to be said, there has been an increase in tariffs since 2013. In fact, the last adjustments to tariffs down the wall in 2015, and the majority of tariffs were significantly reduced, especially in places like Liscard, Heswell and West Kirby. Given that there hasn't been a rise in tariffs for 4 years, I don't think the 23 rise is unreasonable. The 23 rise needs to be taken in context. We look at the technologies that will make it easier for people to pay for the tariffs. This administration has also invested over £5 million in our areas of work, including an investment of £500,000 of council's own capital. On top of that, we invested a third of £100,000 in our street lighting network. Likewise, the modest charges for country parks is also, I feel, reasonable. Considering we spent around £5.6 million maintaining them, again, despite the financial challenges, we have more green flags than anywhere else in the region. Mr. Mayor, the Tory motion mentioned that Wirral Council taxpayers were repaid by the parks. Was that not the case when the Tory led administration, which led Council to be raised £200,000 worth of income from increased charges for meals on wheels in 2010. Let's think about that for a minute. That's £200,000 worth of income from some of those vulnerable in our society. I'm sorry, but not without tears from the Tories have been cut. Mr. Mayor, you would think the Tories being Tories that they would at least be a list of consistency. Maybe Councillor Green thinks that Council taxpayers should be paid to buy their government and keep ours. You should drop a text to the new leaders of Tory and share a portion of the councils as they all charge for parking in the country parks. Also, for the Lib Dems Eastleigh, they also charge. Special mention, however, should go to Essex County Council. You know, the ones who switched off the 70% of the streetlights. They not only charge for parking, they also charge for new paddles to park their country parks. Compassionate conservatives will be aware. Mr. Mayor, this motion is special council meeting is political opportunism and staff work. Our Labour Council does the right thing and reject it.
Still angry. anxious about the future and still anxious about the diversion of trade. When the scrutiny committee met for a presentation around about the 8th or 9th of January, that was the first time that members had seen a detailed breakdown. Prior to that, it had been confined to one line only in a document that the Cabinet considered in December. It's interesting that the Council, in Wirral view, which we mentioned several times, was able to write in its January edition about the car parking being proposed on page 9, and to explain the way that people could in fact make representations through an interesting but complicated series of computer steps to get there. Because the public were more better organised than that, rightly so, and set out to produce many petitions, independent petitions, and also ones that my party and other parties were associated with, hence the phrase unprecedented opposition in the Councillor Green's proposal. Mr. Mayor, strangely enough, it takes some time to assemble a photo shoot. A photo shoot is a photograph that appears in a press release, a photograph that gets in the Globe, the Standard, and of course in Wirral View. And the Wirral View, on this occasion, was being delivered round Bromwell Easton the Saturday before the leader signed the order on the Monday cancelling the project. So it's a strange twist of events. For months we complain the newspaper doesn't get delivered, and the week in which the leader decides the council car parking charges are being abolished, the newspaper gets out in advance to say they're being abolished. Council meets on the Saturday morning, and I shall have done on Monday. So, Mr. Mayor, when the council wants to do something, it can't. On this occasion, it still has a choice, and it could abandon the increase in charges on economic grounds. It could also take a clear decision on a health policy, if we're encouraging people to walk, to cycle, and to take exercise. Introducing charges that put them off in different places, it would be wrong. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
And the opposition is go and demand from your government what you should have been doing
last year.
Thank you.
no intention of doing the full hit of parking. No. They actually only ever intended doing the parking in the council areas of green and natural beauty. I'm just wondering if in fact this has totally been a complete ruse by the Labour administration in order to do what they intended to do, which was to destroy the open spaces that we have.
Thank you. change their mind. And therefore, I would see no reason personally why I should not vote on both occasions. And I shall do so.
Okay, thank you very much.
How about Tory prejudice?
We've heard the advice. Now call for the seconders. Councillor Renner.
About the poll tax.
Mr. Mayor, it's always good to see the Labour administration do a U-turn on some poll tax proposals. And no doubt they would like to tell us that they have listened. In fact, I think that you've already mentioned that you have been listening to the public. And that you have clearly acted accordingly, or have you? Well, you best know the answer to that, Bill. But so, Mr. Mayor, I thought I was probably one of the only cynics in this council, but clearly Councillor David Burgess is just as cynical as I am, because I've written down here something really which David's already said. Did the Labour Party ever really intend to invoke all these charges when they put on their full package? I'm not quite sure. Perhaps Bill, you'd like to tell us that. So then you start taking a few of those pieces back, and we, the public, and ourselves here on these benches are supposed to be grateful. Well, if you can be grateful, we are not. Because, Mr. Mayor, Labour still intend to force unnecessary increased parking charges on many of the existing sites, but worse still, you are hell-bent on introducing parking charges on our green and open spaces. In short, they're telling residents, as colleagues have said, to pay twice, and that, Mr. Mayor, is nothing short of daylight robbery. No doubt Labour, as they have, Mr. Mayor, have already waxed lyrical about it's all the wicked Tory government's fault. Yeah. Benefits of this.
Shields.